Cryogenic milling explained. Heterogeneous powder blends can lead to heterogeneous VCM samples. Cryogenic milling reduces the particle size and makes mixtures homogeneous on a micrometer length scale. Subsequent diffusion during the melting of the VCM process creates a homogeneous sample, as illustrated here with the uniform blue sample. We demonstrate the process with a SPECS freezer mill, as this is the most user-friendly mill for our application. Here, you can see the parts of the milling vial. The assembling starts by inserting the impactor into the milling jar before adding the material. Adding the impactor after filling the powdery material may cause undesired material discharge by the induced airflow. Add the pre-weight components of your formulation to the milling jar and close it. First, we fill the pool with about 4 liters of liquid nitrogen. Be sure to wear safety equipment as instructed in the vendor's manual, and that the operators know the risks that liquid nitrogen bears. Fill until the clearly visible fill line. Add the vial to the milling chamber and close the lid of the SPECS mill slowly. Fast closing of the lid will cause spills of liquid nitrogen on the work surface and potentially on the operator. You can then start your predefined program. The outside of the milling vial is stationary while an electromagnet hits the impactor back and forth. We recommend a program with a pre-cooling time of 3 minutes to ensure that the material is thoroughly chilled before the milling begins. This is followed by 3 milling cycles of 3 minutes with intercooling times of 2 minutes. The intercooling step removes the heat of the high-energy input during the milling and prevents undesired softening. Milling programs like this generate over 16,000 potential hits on the loaded material, ensuring perfect mixing. It's time to take it out. Wear safety gear and use a magnetic pin to extract the milling vial from the chamber. It is essential to warm the milling vial up before opening it. Otherwise, the powdery sample will attract humidity from the air, resulting in a moist material. A good practice is repurposing the VCM Essentials cooling unit to warm up the milling vial. Start by vacuum clamping the milling vial adapter on the cooling unit and place the vial inside. Engage the compressed air to bring it back to room temperature. The ice will first melt, and the water will dry up quickly. When the lower half is done, flip the milling vial over to unfreeze the upper half. An ice and water-free surface indicates that everything is back at room temperature, and you can open the milling vial. Remove the impactor with the magnetic handle and discharge the powder into a suitable container. Did you notice the color change of the material? The API, in our case, had a distinct blue color, which was uniformly distributed within the formulation by the milling action. This uniform mixture is the perfect starting material for the VCM process to obtain uniform and homogeneous ASDs, as with any other method. The only difference? You saved material and time. Check out our other videos in the Melt Prep knowledge base and bring your ASD development skills to the next level.